Shantanu Gupta is an author and a supporter of the BJP, and he joins us. Shantanu, just to take off on the point Suhasini raised, and you know, just also this point that, you know, the BJP on one hand, I'm sure you'd agree, can't say we don't care what the international media thinks of us, but also get excited by a Time magazine cover on Mr. Modi. Or Mr. Modi, you know, has written op-eds for the New York Times as recently as a couple of months ago on Mahatma Gandhi. So which is it? Are you concerned that the Prime Minister today is being, you know, described as authoritarian, as an autocrat in many, many Western media editorials and the press?
See, Nidhi, anti-Modism is an industry since 2002, and many journalists in India and many journalists abroad, across the globe have thrived on this industry. And I'm sure you know the names I'm referring to. Now these Indian journalists also get paid to write for Washington Post and other newspapers. See, till 2002,
so what,
US decided that they will not give the visa once.
I don't understand the idea that journalists are being
paid. That's fine.
If they are writing for someone,
it's an industry in itself. Lot of people made their career just out of anti-Modism, and that's a fact. That's their brand that they speak. Whatever Modi will do, they will do anti-peace. So that's an industry, but Modi brand grew. More and more anti-Modism article came in India and abroad. The Modi brand grew always. And we have seen the rockstar type events he have done with diaspora. He can gather more crowds, the local politicians of that country. How he rubbed shoulders
so
with the top-notch.
What I want to understand is, even if I take your argument for a minute that the Washington Post doesn't matter or the New York Times doesn't matter, the fact is, A, the Prime Minister has written for the New York Times. If you think it's a sort of a lefty newspaper that isn't worthy of attention, why is the PM writing op-eds for it? One. Two, there are enough sort of more right-of-center publications like the Wall Street Journal, like the Financial Times, that have been far more bullish and more supportive of Mr. Modi and his policies since his election in 2014. And they are now criticizing India very strongly, saying that India is sliding into authoritarianism. I'm asking you, when that happens, are you not concerned? Not just about the guys that you don't like anyway.
If I count four or five major so-called nationalistic, which you call nationalist movement of Narendra Modi, be it surgical strike 1 and 2, abrogation of 370, maybe triple talaq, and finally CA and NRC. There is no government of the world which made a very formal statement apart from a Malaysia here and Turkey there. That's all. So
they've all criticized India's actions.
I doubt the image.
They've not criticized 370, you're right, but they've criticized India's actions, but they've been very critical of the NRC. And they've been very critical of the handling of the protests. They're very critical of the internet shutdown and detentions in Kashmir.
And many world capitals have spoken on record about that. I don't think so. There are very many countries who have issued any country official.
I can list
not
them
major
for you.
Any country official statement. We have seen
the United States.
How we have cornered Pakistan and China in Azhar Masood case. How we have used our muscle in International Court of Justice. So Indian muscle is intact, but you are right.
Indian
the international
muscle is intact.
Media has to be. A lot of people take their.
I want to ask Ambassador Keith something
right.
about that.
Indian
about the Indian,
Indian
muscle.
Story has to be communicated well.
Okay. Okay. You're saying it's a communication problem, not a problem. Is that actually what the government thinks, Ambassador Keith?
I think that we have that we have from time immemorial. Huh. I think that there is a need for an international channel and a bunch of international newspapers which are running from India, so that which will talk about the problems in UK from France to US, which we don't do.
Achha, we should be doing more of that.
A BBC comes to India and finds our problems.
Okay, Shantanu, one sec. Okay. Yeah.
This is nothing new. I joined the Foreign Service a year before the emergency. And there was despondency in the rest of the world because they said, how can Nehru's daughter do this? So this is not the first time. You know, why did John F. Kennedy come to a help after 62 debacle? Because he said the democracy in democratic India is the counterpoint, is the counterforce to a communist China. Now to say, no, they're not doing it to China, why they're doing it to us, begs the question, because we are not China. We don't want to be China.
Of course.
Secondly, these are not Western values. I'm really surprised if democracy or liberalism or not. Buddha was born here. Humanitarian impulses have gone from here. Humanitarian thought has gone from India. So these are very much Indian, indigenous thought processes, which we have to respect. And that is why India is seen as the counterpoint to China. If India is going to be another China, it will be a very poor China.